Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of PyCharm IDE, that is PyCharm 2022.3 on a Windows operating system. So let's begin. Now to install the latest version of PyCharm, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser, and in the address bar you need to just simply search with PyCharm and enter, and you'll be getting this www.jetbrains.com. So just simply click on PyCharm and it will going to redirect to the official site of JetBrains, and see PyCharm is there. So here you need to just simply click on download, and it will going to redirect you to the download page of PyCharm, and see we have 2022.3 as our latest version. You can close these cookies. So here you have two options. One is professional and community one. Community one is the free one, and these are the operating system, so Windows, macOS and Linux. It is available for all three operating system. I'm going to download the community one, which is free. So just simply click on download, and it will going to start downloading our PyCharm. Now since I have already downloaded it, I'll just simply cancel it. I'll just simply go to my download directory, and you can see that our PyCharm is already been downloaded over here. To install, just simply double click on the installer. It will ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes, and let's minimize our download directory and our browser as well. And here just simply click on next. This is our installation destination. Keep this default. Click on next, and here check this, you know, PyCharm community edition, and also check this open folder as project. So by just simply right clicking of any folder, you can open that folder as a project. And .py means .python, so that is what you know, we want to create associations with PyCharm. And also check add bin to path. This is a very important step, so this will automatically set our environment variable, and then just simply click on next and install, and see our installation has rightly begun. Also our desktop shortcut is also created. So you know, let's wait to finish this process. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our installation is pretty much completed. So it's telling whether you would like to reboot your system now, or you would like to manually reboot later. So I'll recommend you to, you know, reboot your system now and then click on finish and then come back again to this video. Okay, I'll be also doing the same. So after rebooting your system, you'll be again landed over to your desktop, and you'll be seeing this, you know, the desktop shortcut of PyCharm. So just simply double click on that shortcut to launch our PyCharm. It will ask you for, you know, to import the PyCharm settings. So if you haven't installed PyCharm previously, then just, you know, simply do not import setting and okay, and it will going to launch our PyCharm 2022.3, and see it has rightly launched. And it might show you that Windows Defender is blocking some of the features. Just simply, you know, allow access, and there you go, welcome to PyCharm. Just simply maximize it. And here I'll be showing you how to create a new project. So just simply click on new project, and here we need to give your project name. So let's give the project name as a hello all, right? So hello all, and our Python 3.9 base interpreter will be, you know, automatically downloaded, so not a big problem. Just simply click on create, and it will going to download our Python as well. So you need to have an active internet connection for that. So it will, you can see that it is currently downloading and installing our Python 3.9. Since Python was not installed on my machine previously, so it will also going to install Python along with PyCharm. So as you can see that our Python is also installed, and our project hello all is also created. So they have already created this print hi method, and here is our main method. So from where we are calling this print hi by passing this parameter PyCharm. So if I just simply run this project, you can see hi PyCharm is rightly shown. So this hi and then PyCharm is, we are passing this as a parameter, so it is getting into here, and hi PyCharm is printed. So if you change this PyCharm with hi Geeky Script and just simply, you know, run it, you can see hi Geeky Script rightly shown. You can write your name or anything you can wish. Okay, so that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.